So we are discussing about the software quality in the TQM, that is the Total Quality Management. The concept TQM originated in the year 1985, and the main thrust or focus was to create such a work culture when all organization members, they participate in improving the processes as well as the products and the services. There were various authors to this. So this TQM, Total Quality Management, has many meanings. It means the style with the goal, the success joining the quality with the customer satisfaction, and the base is always to create a quality culture. In the TQM, the examples of successful usage of this TQM in computer industry is HP's Total Quality Control TQC, Motorola's Six Sigma strategy, IBM's market-driven quality, IBM's. So the summary of TQM is the customer focus. That is, the objective is always to achieve total customer satisfaction and the process. We want to reduce process variations and to achieve continuous process improvement. And through process improvement, of course, the product quality will be enhanced. And what is the human side of the quality? We want a company-wide or the organization-wide quality culture. Then we talk about the measurement and analysis, and the objective here is to drive continuous improvement in all quality parameters by the goal-oriented measurement system. So the main element of TQM, or Total Quality Management, which we tend to speak about continuous improvement, is customer focus, the process improvement, and the human side of quality. And on the base, we always have the measures, the models, and the measurement and the analysis. There is another view of TQM also. As you see here, TQM, as we said, total participation, customer focus, planning process, process management, and process improvement. And these are the 8 total quality management principles. Principle 1 is customer focus, leadership driven, involvement of people, process approach, system approach to management, continuous improvement, factual approach to decision making, and mutually beneficial supplier relationship. There are models of software quality: McCall's quality model and Boehm's model, Forbes or Forbes Plus, Dromi quality model, and ISO quality models. In the McCall's quality model, one of the first quality models way back in 1977, actually it is called as a McCall quality model or quality triangle, McCall's triangle of quality. So he divided into the quality into 3 terms. When the operations, when the software or product is subjected to operations, or they are revising, or they are transiting. In terms of operation, the correctness, the reliability, the efficiency, the integrity, and the usability. In the revision, the maintainability, the flexibility, and testability. In the transition, the portability, the reusability, and interoperability. Based on these 3 type of characteristic with hierarchical or level wise dependency, we have factors, that is, which is external software view for users. The criteria is the internal software view for developers, and the measures, that is the metrics, are used for the measurement. So for factor 1 in McCall's quality model, first was the product operation. So in which we saw the correctness, that is the functionality actually matches with the function specification which is provided by the user. The reliability means the extent to which the system fails or work properly. The efficiency is the usage of system reports, which includes the CPU, disk, memory, or network. The integrity is protection from anyone who is not authorized. The usability is easy to learn and easy to use, and pleasure in using. The factor 2 is the product revision, that is the maintainability. How we are able to find and fix the defect, the ability to make changes which are dictated or come out of business, that means the flexibility, and then the testability. If you want to validate the software requirements, how to do it, the ability of validating is given by the testability. Then the factor 3, that is the product transition. The portability means from one environment to another, how we can transfer, the ability to transfer the software from one environment to another, this is portability. Reusability, how easily we can use the or reuse the components in some other different context or place. Interoperability, the extent, the ease to which the software components, they work together, they are integrated, they interoperate together. In the McCall's quality model, we can see that all those we have discussed, the factor 1, 2, 3, that is product revision, transition and operation, there are certain operations which are involved. For example, let me take one of these. Say, usability. For this, the operability, training and communicativeness, these are involved, and likewise for others. So the quality measure aims to capture some of the aspects of quality criteria. The quality factors synthesized should provide a complete software quality picture, and the quality is evaluated by answering yes or no questions and then summarizing the answers. In the Boehm's quality model, this was defined in 1978. This is a hierarchical model of software quality characteristics. So there are characteristics at three levels in Boehm's quality model. The highest level, the intermediate model and the primitive. The highest level characteristics, it represents the basic high level requirements of actual use to which the evaluation of software quality could be put, that is the general utility of the software. The higher level characteristics, it addresses three main questions that a buyer of the software has, what he presents to you. That is, how well can I use it as is, easily, reliably, efficiently. Maintainability means how easy this software is to understand and to modify and to retest. Portability, can I use if I change my environment. The intermediate level characteristics, it represents seven quality factors: portability, reliability, efficiency, usability, testability and understandability, along with the modifiability, that is the flexibility. In the Boehm's quality model, the lowest level structure of the characteristics hierarchy is the primitive characteristic metric hierarchy. That means the general utility, as we saw, the as is, maintainability, these are portability, reliability, efficiency, human engineering, testability, understandability, modifiability. These levels we have already seen. So this is the first level, second level, this is the highest, this is the mid, now the lowest level. And this lowest level includes the device dependency, self-containedness. And these are all related with these, the middle level, some or the other way. For example, say the structuredness. The structuredness has relationship with the modifiability, the understandability and testability also. So let us compare these two models, McCall and Boehm. All these quality factors, which starts from correctness and of course the economy. So where Boehm has a thrust, a given thrust, and McCall has taken all these, just leaving this functionality. In the FORBS or FORBS Plus quality model, the FORBS stands for functionality, usability, reliability, performance and supportability. The FORBS model, originally it was presented by Robert Grady in 80s and presented in 1992. And then Rational Software, it has extended this FORBS to FORBS Plus. In this model, as we said, that FORBS stands for functionality, that is, what are the feature sets, the capabilities and security. In the terms of usability, of course, the human factors, the aesthetics, the consistency in the user interface, online and context sensitive helps, the wizards and agents, the user documentation and the training materials. The R, reliability, the frequency and severity of change, recoverability, predictability, accuracy and MTTF, MTDBF, that is mean time between failure. The performance, the conditions on functional requirements such as speed, efficiency, availability, accuracy, throughput, response time, recovery time and resource usage. The supportability means the testability, extensibility, adaptability, maintainability, compatibility, configurability, serviceability, installability, localizability, that is the internationalization. So the FORBS category are of two different types: F, functional, URPS means non-functional. So these categories can be used as both product requirements as well as the assessment of product quality. Now we come to Dromey's quality model. It was proposed in 1995. The main presumptions were the quality evaluation, they differ or differs for each product, and a more dynamic idea for modeling the process is needed to be wide enough to apply to various variety of systems. The model is focusing on the relationship between the quality attributes and the sub attributes, and there is an attempt to connect software product properties with the software quality attributes. So the main elements or key elements are product properties which influence the quality, the high quality or high level quality attributes, the means of linking the product properties with the quality attributes. So the software products, the implementation includes the product properties like correctness, internal, text, contextual and descriptive. In the quality attribute, the correctness says functionality, reliability. Internal dependent on the maintainability, efficiency, reliability. The contextual means maintainability, reusability, portability and reliability. And the descriptiveness means maintainability, reusability, portability, usability. That means these may be reused also in the product properties. So the model is structured around 5-step processes. First, we choose a set of high level quality attributes necessary for the evaluation, and we list the components or modules in your system. Then we identify quality carrying properties of the component modules, that is the quality of the component that have the most impact on the product properties from the list above. And then we determine how each property affects the quality attributes, and we evaluate the model and identify the weaknesses then. And what about the software quality according to IEEE? The degree to which the system component of process meets specified requirement. The degree to which system component of process meets the customer or user needs or expectations. So it meets the specified requirement and meets the customer expectation. And according to Pressman, software quality is conformance to the explicitly stated functional and performance requirement, explicitly documented development standard, and implicit characteristics that are expected of all professionally developed software. The foundation of quality assessment is the software requirement specification according to Pressman, and the lack of conformance to requirement is the lack of quality. And the specified standard define a set of development criteria that guide the manner in which the software is engineered. So if the criteria are not followed, lack of quality will almost surely result, and the software has to meet implicit requirements also. So what are the difference between these two views? According to IEEE definition, the main thing in the quality assurance is to satisfy the user. Pressman now emphasizes the software development process. Both definitions agree that a high quality is impossible without the conformance to this specification requirement. So let us summarize this model. There exist many different quality models for software product. The factors used in the model, they overlap, and more complete definitions are needed for their use. The model do not agree in terminology or even on what factors should be included. Scopes of definition may vary. So it is developed, ISO quality model, and it tries to summarize the experience from different models. The comparison of the model is like this. Either you take McCall, Boehm, Evans, the DIOS, the ISO 9126, the FURPS, the Dromey, the SCI, that is the CMM one, and the SQUARE. So the software quality models, the age or the era, how they came into being, it started with McCall, then came Boehm, then FURPS, Dromey, and of course in this between we have ISO 9126. Then various came, and the most marked one after this were the ISO. You know, of course it started here, and now we have various open source quality models also, as you see Qual OSS, Open VRR, like this. So this was a brief view about the software quality and what are the models and how you are going to achieve them using one of them. And you must understand that quality is always achieved when you follow the conformity rule, and if you follow some standard, that is well, then most agreed. Thank you so much.